Now no one told you life was gonna be this way. You're looking for some help to get you through the day.
Good morning, Sunday School. I hope you're all well. Have you ever noticed that sometimes doing the right thing can be hard? You know, like not looking at someone else's paper during a hard test. Or finding something really cool and returning it instead of keeping it for yourself. It can be extra hard when you get in trouble or punished for doing the right thing. This week, we see the story of the disciple Stephen, who gets in trouble for telling others about Jesus. But before the story, let's spend some time in prayer and worship. Will you join me? Eyes closed, heads bowed. Gentlemen, hats off. Let me pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this morning, for a chance to get together to worship and praise you. And thank you for the story of Stephen, that as we will learn, the Christian life is not always easy, but you have promised that you will be with us always. God, we love you and we thank you in your precious and holy name. Amen.
It's my rock.
Jesus is the rock.
the rock.
Maybe midnight or midday, never early, never late. He gon' stand by what he claimed, lived enough life to save.
I heard your heart, I see your pain, out in the dark, out in the rain. Feel so alone, feel so afraid. I heard you pray in Jesus' name. It may be midnight or midday, it's never early, never late. He gon' stand by what he claimed. I lived enough life to say. On the way. Sometimes it's days, sometimes it's years. Some face a lifetime of falling tears. But he's in the darkness, he's in the cold. Just like the morning, he always shows. It may be midnight or midday, it's never early, never late. He gon' stand by what he claimed. I lived enough life to say.
Stephen was one of Jesus' followers. God blessed Stephen and gave him power to do great wonders and signs. One day, some Jews began to argue with Stephen. The Holy Spirit helped Stephen speak with wisdom, so no matter how hard the Jews tried, they could not win the argument. But the Jews lied about Stephen. They said he had spoken against God. The people dragged Stephen to the Sanhedrin, the Jewish court, and told more lies. We heard Stephen say that Jesus will destroy the temple and change the laws that Moses gave us, they said. Is this true? The high priest asked Stephen. Stephen began to preach about Jesus. He reminded the court about Abraham. God had made promises to Abraham and his son Isaac. He reminded them about Joseph and Moses. God kept Joseph safe when his brothers tried to hurt him. And God used Joseph to help all his people during a famine. When God's people lived in Egypt, God called Moses to rescue his people from Pharaoh. Moses led God's people away from Egypt, but they turned against Moses and against God. God did not give up on his people, though. He was working out a plan. God worked through Joshua and David and Solomon. The religious leaders knew these stories from the Old Testament. Stephen told them these stories to explain that Jesus was the Messiah God had promised. But just like their ancestors rejected and killed the prophets in the Old Testament, these Jewish leaders had rejected Jesus and murdered him. Stephen's words made the Jewish leaders so angry. Stephen was filled with the Holy Spirit. He looked up to heaven and saw Jesus standing there. "Look," he said, I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. The Jewish leaders screamed at the top of their lungs. They covered their ears and rushed at Stephen. They threw him out of the city and began throwing stones at him. Stephen called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he said, "Lord, do not hold the sin against them." After this, Stephen died. Jesus told his followers that they would be persecuted, hated, hurt, or even killed for loving him. Jesus also said that those who suffer for him would be blessed. We can face suffering in this life because Jesus suffered first. He died and then rose again, and he is waiting for us in heaven.
Now no one told you life was gonna be this way. You're looking for some help to get you through the day. You'll find the answers in this book right here. The Lord will speak to you and help you to conquer your fear, 'cause he'll be there for you.
Just read your Bible and pray.
He'll be there for you.
In your heart he will stay.
He'll be there for you.
And he'll strengthen